The M113 APC is perhaps one of the most ubiquitous armored fighting vehicle designs in service today. Being little more than an aluminum box on tracks, the M113 is still in service in as many as 50 different armies, with a number of variants fulfilling a variety of roles, including command and control, fire support, and anti-tank duties. Given the vehicle's adaptability, it should come as no surprise that some non-military organizations have taken a shine to a vehicle that can protect occupants from external hazards. For this reason, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, or NASA, operated four of them for the evacuation of astronauts in case of rocket failure during launch. Today, we take an in-depth look at their usage. Welcome to another Tank Encyclopedia voiced article. I'm your host, Dan, and today I'll be looking at the M113 Armored Rescuer, NASA's firefighting and rescue vehicle. If you like what we do and want to see more, don't forget to like the video and, if you haven't already, subscribe so you don't miss a single upload.
This video has been sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes covering all kinds of interesting subjects. From photography to 3D modeling, music production, and so much more. In fact, I and some of our team members are using Skillshare. And Tern is currently following a class covering Capture One by Kat Chadow, which is really helping her master editing these pictures he took in Rome. This class is full of convenient information that you can return to listening to whenever you want to, and is very intuitive and easy to understand. Now, personally, what makes Skillshare special for me is that it is designed to give you an effective and pressure-free experience that will help you learn and discover knowledge. Skillshare doesn't display any ads, does not have any additional paywalls, no bait and switches, you are free to explore absolutely everything. And if it couldn't get any better, Skillshare is running a promotion. What kind of promotion? Well, the first 1,000 subscribers that manage to click the link in the description below will get a 1-month free trial for Skillshare. The first 1,000 subscribers to use the link on our description box or use our code TANKENCYCLOPEDIA will get a 1-month free trial for Skillshare. Thank you for checking out Skillshare. Ads like these help us keep growing. And now, onto the video.
From the early days of Project Apollo, NASA's project to land a man on the moon, the issue of how to evacuate the rocket if something went wrong was a key concern. Naturally, it took a lot of time and money to train an astronaut, and NASA would rather they stayed alive if something went wrong. Losing a rocket would be embarrassing enough. The initial plan was rather ingenious. Zip lines. The astronauts could zip line from the rocket to a concrete bunker, where a vehicle would be housed. The astronauts would climb into the vehicle and floor it as fast as they could away from the compromised rocket or shuttle. Enter the M113, at the time, America's battle taxi, armored, enclosed, and just what was needed to carry astronauts out of danger. In self-evacuation vehicles, all astronauts were trained to operate it, a course that some found quite fun. As well as taking the astronauts out of danger, the M113s were also used to carry firefighters into danger. In the event the astronauts could not reach the bunker, two M113s were kept on standby. Each carried a firefighting crew, equipped with silver suits and a self-contained breathing apparatus. These M113s would carry the firefighters towards the compromised vehicle, whereupon they would dismount, rescue the astronauts, re-enter the vehicle, and get away from what was likely to be a raging inferno. The firefighters had just 10 minutes to do all this, and so trained extensively for a situation where delay would be fatal. The vehicles were stationed around 4,750 feet from the launch site to reduce reaction times. For their new role, the M113s were suitably modified. Asbestos was added to the vehicle's exterior, either as a paste or as additional paneling. At least one vehicle was equipped with a large rectangular shield on the front, possibly as an additional protection against heat or fire, or as a dozer blade to clear debris away. Vehicles 1 and 3 also had a large cab-like structure added to the roof over the commander's hatch. However, this appears to have been a temporary addition, as more recent photos show the vehicles without this distinctive modification. Initially, the vehicles appear to have been a dark color, with numerous numbers on the front and sides. During the 70s, the color scheme changed to full white, with the vehicle number emblazoned in red. At some point, this was changed again to a luminous green with a horizontal reflective stripe. although the red numbers remained. The M113s remained in use within NASA for around 50 years, unstationed for every launch in the event of failure on the ground. In 2013, NASA announced the retirement of the M113, which took place in 2015. Upon retirement, the M113s were replaced with surplus Cayman mine-resistant ambush-protected vehicles. Faster, more spacious, and affording the same protection as the M113s, the MRAPs will continue to provide astronauts with a quick getaway vehicle as NASA seeks a return to manned spaceflights. Following retirement, the fate of the M113s is unknown, although they have likely been scrapped. Vehicle number one, at least, has since become a gate guardian of the Kennedy Space Center. This concludes our look at NASA's M113s. What do you think? Are there any other AFVs you'd choose as an astronaut's escape vehicle? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, and if you want to be updated on new vehicles, subscribe if you haven't already. And if you want to contribute more directly, we also have a Patreon and PayPal where you can support us. It helps keep the lights on and helps create bigger and better videos for you. Until next time, keep us in your sights.